Our customers are definitely looking to move their technology forward, but at the same time, they're concerned with their existing investments in legacy technologies like WebLogic and WebSphere. They want a path to the future, and at least for developers, that future is Linux containers and OpenShift. So with this demo, I want to show you exactly how easy it is to do today. So what we're going to do is take an existing monolithic Java EE application to the cloud using OpenShift and JBoss EAP, our modern lightweight Java EE app platform. So to get started, I've loaded the application into the Red Hat development suite, which is our desktop Eclipse IDE. The application is called DayTrader. It's a high-performance stock trading application built with a number of Java EE technologies. So let's have a quick look at the source code. You can see there's a number of stateless EJBs, which contain the application business logic. We have a number of JMS topics and queues, which handle asynchronous trades. Entity beans handle the persistence to and from the database. And as you'll see in a moment, it's all topped off with a gloriously retro user interface built on JSP technologies, along with everyone's favorite tag, the blink tag, because, well, why not? So we're going to run this application through the Red Hat Application Migration Toolkit. So that toolkit contains an analysis engine which looks at the source code of the app, along with the web reporting engine which generates a report showing you the issues that it found, helpful pointers and documentation links. Also, it classifies the different issues based on whether they're mandatory or optional, and applies story points to give you kind of an idea, a rough idea of the difficulty in the migration. So I've been working on this application for a few minutes before this session. I've got a few issues left. I've got three issues left, and I'm going to show you what they look like and what the process is. So with the migration toolkit, we're offered quick fixes. So if I right-click and say Preview Quick Fix, it will show me exactly what needs to change based on the issues that it found and the best practices from our history of working with customers. So we can see that the code changes here. You can make changes yourself if you want to, but I'm just going to go ahead and apply that fix, and that issue is resolved. I can go ahead and do the same for the remaining two. I'll just go ahead and apply them directly, and we should be done here. So now, great, I've got my application migrated from the proprietary WebLogic legacy platform over to the open source flexible and modern JBoss EAP platform, but that's not the best part. With the native OpenShift integration in the IDE, I can simply take my migrated application and drag and drop it onto a Linux container running on OpenShift, and now I'm cloud ready. So I dragged it, I dropped it, it's built and deployed out to OpenShift, so let's go have a look at what that looks like. So here's the OpenShift web console. We can see the application has been deployed. If I click here, I can actually see the gloriously retro UI that I was telling you about, so I can log in, do some trades, see how much my account balance is worth, and other various things within the application. But more importantly, the application didn't need any re-architecting. We support both the traditional stateful Java EE workloads as well as the more cloud-native modern workloads. So no re-architecture required. I simply built the application. It's built, it's combined with the JBoss EAP runtime, and that result is turned into a Linux container, which now gives me great flexibility. So for example, I can create an auto-scaling situation where I can meet changing demand based on the traffic hitting my application. I can also do things like build CI/CD pipelines. I built a pipeline here, which I'm going to start and explain kind of what it does. So this pipeline is basically taking my existing monolithic application, and then using the Linux container that it was built into, it promotes it across various environments. So from the developer's desktop to a QA environment to a staging environment, and ultimately out to production in what we call a blue-green deployment in this case, where the application is deployed to production, but no traffic is routed to it. Once I'm happy with the results of the tests and I'm confident that the changes to the application are solid, I can then go ahead and approve that and start switching the traffic over to the application, the new application. So it looks like my pipeline is done, so I'll go ahead and approve that to production. And while that's going, we're going to do a couple other things. So with the time savings I've got with automation and the advanced deployment techniques and CI/CD pipelines, now I can take my developers who were originally tasked with keeping the lights on, basically, and now they can do things like innovate and come up with new things. So for example, I've created a small microservice using Wildfly Swarm technology. This microservice basically will provide a modern RESTful API onto my existing EJB-based monolith, mission critical monolith, so that developers who prefer that style of integration can now have access to this application, which was previously kind of walled off from them by a decade of technology change. So now that the application looks like it deployed, so let's go and shift back to OpenShift. It looks like the microservice is coming up. At the same time, remember my rolling update is still in progress. This rolling update occurred at the end of my pipeline, which takes my new application and spins it up slowly while the old application comes down at the same time, and allows the in-flight transactions and any other kind of data that may be in flight to not be lost. So I maintain state, I maintain the transactions, I maintain my business, and I don't lose customers. So again, while that's occurring, it looks like my microservice is now deployed. So let's go ahead and test that out while the update is running here. So we'll go ahead and issue a trade and buy some stock. Okay, so my microservice looks like it's up and it's deployed, and I was able to purchase stock through the RESTful interface. So great. So this is just one example of taking an existing monolithic Java application from a legacy platform over to the cloud with OpenShift and JBoss EAP.